made you decide to come and party and make the record launch at the Belmont?
A few things. I got started at the beginning. The owner of the Belmont used to be a bouncer here. He bought the club from his boss when his boss said he was closing down the club. He bought it and now he owns it. Going further back than that, the actual owner now is somebody that I've known since I was 16 years old, from way back in the days.
You're always connected to people you know a long time, like Fitz Moja, this Moja.
Yeah, I feel like a mobster. Yeah, it's crazy. It's like, I have good connects, I won't lie. I have good people around me and people that support me and whatnot. So we also do our hip-hop karaoke night here, which is huge. It's huge, huge, huge.
What's the night?
We do it once a month. We had our sixth one a couple of weeks ago here. We're trying to find a date for the next one, but it's going to go down. It's packed, full of McGill students, so yeah, that's all I can say on camera. It's packed.
Back.
And yeah, there's a lot
but,
of people.
But as far as your album, Plugging Your Night is good, but as far as your album goes, how many songs on the album?
There's 16.
I heard word of mouth, because he told me you made a song with DJ Manifest.
Yeah.
He works with everybody, doesn't he?
It's crazy, because that's one of the first tracks that we did, and there wasn't even a question of cutting that track off.
All good, isn't it?
There was no, yeah. All good featuring Lisa Marie Mackey, who's in the building, actually. Wow, she sang her soul out on that track, man.
She
sang
did?
Her soul out, yeah. Manifest, he's one of the city's finest producers. Not only does, you know, he could DJ a party for you, but, man, can he produce? He gave me bangers for days, and, you know, I still have an arsenal of more beats from Manifest that I got to go through, because he just keeps doing it well.
Well, you know who he reminds me to, because I've been seeing him around since he was 14 or 15 years old. I used to hang with DJ Storm when he was younger, and he used to bring him to these nights and to these clubs like Purple Lays, like all of the area, and then they used to bring him to... what's the other club we used to go all the time? Circus.
Yeah.
He's got a huge like fan base and everything, and he kept maintaining. He reminds me of Sam Sever. Sam Sever was the little white boy who was doing the drum programming on Run DMC album.
Yeah,
from Brooklyn. So this this cat, or even you have a lot of people that worked on drum patterns for people who come up with bad beats. Been making beats for a long time.
Yep. And it's so, for me, it's so inspiring that, you know, I would even try to do it myself, you know, sometimes. About myself an MPC, you know, bang out a few beats, get some tips from the guys that are already doing it and whatnot. And the whole creativity process, I can see why guys stay up, like, overnight making beats, or they stay up for 2 days just working on the same beat. Meanwhile, their significant other next door that's trying to sleep is like, are you still playing that beat? Not realizing that you've been running that beat for like 16 hours. God damn! You know, so it's something that I find very addictive. Once you get in, it's hard to stop.
I've seen DJ Storm. He's still your sidekick. I've seen him upstairs.
Yeah, it's all famine. Orion Revolution too.
Orion Revolution too.
Yeah. We will always support each other no matter what we do. You know, if Storm opens up a brothel next week, I'll go for the opening, man.
You still stay down after all these years.
Yeah. That's
like
the DG mentality. NDG mentality. I noticed that anybody that's from around DG, we all acknowledge each other. And even though some may have never spoken to the other person, we know you're from the area, you know?
Well, NDG is, you know, since 1970, there was not too many, like, black families, so the kids met in school, the parents met after school, church.
And
in the park on Sundays, because there was not too many parks where the brothers would go, but all the brothers would go to the same park.
Exactly. Yeah. Brothers in the same park, and, you know, Rastas were running it.
Right? Blessing to teaching, you know, Rasta. They done though, because, you know, the intellectual rules, you know, read the good book, you know, train the mind.
Yeah.
Do you think we're gonna feel that? Do you think your album transcends that? meaning that vibe of flow like water, the lyrics in the album, is the spirit transcend?
Yeah.
Yeah?
It started when I wrote on the beats that I got. Like, those demanded that I be fluid on those beats. And
well, the subject is real fluid. I mean, you know, the depth, like, you got good-looking girls with, but inside, outside, you know, but the cover looks good, the logo's good, lyrics good. You're happy from everybody's performances. But is the lyrics too, like, give me an example or two of the song there. I heard a little bit of the tracks there, but not all the album. But talk to me about a little bit about the morals, the values in the album. The
first and foremost, it's always been about community for me. That's what hip-hop is based on. It's based on community, and that reflects in all of my songs one way or another, whether it's, you know, talking about, you know, situations that my friends are going through that I grew up with, or, you know, how things have changed from now till then. I'm still doing that compared to what, you know, what the community is saying. It's like a community report kind of thing, you know? And, you know, flows, it's good to have flows, but when you don't have content and something that interests people, it's, you know, it's harder to keep it going.
You know, Guru Gangstar, rest in peace, said it good, you know. It's mostly the voice that gets you up, mostly the voice that make you buck. A lot of rappers got, and some got, but if the voice ain't dope, they need to, you know. So, you know, so it's you, and it's always been, and for me, it's an honor to be here tonight, you know, hip-hop-wise, because represent hip-hop, Bronx, New York, Zulu Nation, principal, graffiti, DJ, breakdance, rapping, MC, freestyle. It's nice to see. Plus, you with DSHADE. So, it's one of the most long-lasting group. You're like the EVD of the States. The longest-lasting group that's still together and always did superior lyrics. Zulu Nation, Brandon. I remember that song, Paying Rent.
Yeah.
That's the last thing I posted on my Facebook before I came here. And you know, I run a closed circuit. But it's really, you know, it always made sense. Are we going to find that kind of common sense in your album now? Or you went a different direction?
I never became a nonsensical Negro. So I'm still positive. I'll never be a shucker and a jiver. So I'm always going to say what's on my mind. And unfortunately for some people, it's something intelligent. So, you know, if they can't deal with it, you better read some books. Do something. Because I'm not going to stop telling the truth, and I'm not going to stop revealing how I feel about certain things that happen. And I'm just lucky to have the skill and ability to do it through music at the same time. You know, so I'm going to keep preaching, keep talking to them. Not even preaching necessarily, but I'm going to keep speaking my mind. And be fluid, you know what I mean? And
like water.
Yeah, like water.
About the features wise. Did you do a few features on the album?
I did. Two of my boys from the States, Blue 13 from Baltimore, and Buckshot on the same track called The World We're In. We recorded that in New York City behind Madison Square Garden at one of Buckshot's studios that he records at. And that same day, my boy Anakin Slave recorded with Inspector Deck, so it was an all-star weekend, so to speak. And it was the worst snowstorm that New York has had in years. So, if I'm parking everywhere. I'm parking everywhere. I got, Buckshot, Blue Rum 13. I got some young kids, the Velvet Trench Vibes on there. I got my girl, Natty Soya from the Gamic. She's on there. I didn't tell you, but you got the album now, so you can check it out.
Producers-wise.
Wait,
are we forgetting anybody? I said producers-wise, but features, do you have anybody else you're featured on?
Because
you saying some nice name here. The I don't want to cut you up.
The Narcissist is on there. You know, I got another track produced by my boy Skin Deep, who's right now on the scene. You guys got to go look up Skin Deep, because right now he's putting out fire week after week. Month after month, he's next up, man. His work ethic is crazy. Rick Game is...
Was your security that freestyle night there when I was drunk?
No. I was talking about him that night, but I was there with Lopeshi and Borden. Speaking of which, like, this is the next generation, dude. You know, Borden, all these guys are coming up. Ilansky, Black Gloves, the whole fam, Jericho, all these guys are new cats coming up, and they're shaking it up like it's supposed to be done.
There was a rapper, too, back then. His name was Chuck Ice.
Yeah, Chuck's back. Chuck's back. Yo, Chuck Ice back. Yeah, Chuck's back in Montreal now. He just finished a tour across Ontario and Quebec about a month ago and stuff. So he's been back doing his thing. He's happy about that. He was at Summer Jam 2 years ago. Mm-hmm. I think it was Toronto or something like that.
Did your choice come in here tonight?
Yeah, he should be probably. He'd be upstairs right now.
He should be upstairs right now. Well, I wish you the best luck with this album. I hope everything is going to go as much. What's the distribution? What's the distribution? Are you guys
going doing it through
Canadian, USA?
I'm doing it through worldwide, through iTunes, Amazon. But I got iTunes World, not just iTunes Canada or iTunes America. So iTunes Honduras, if you want.
And but you're not pressing any CDs?
Yeah, I got 1,000 CDs here. But I can move myself. I can move myself. Distribution is, I'm waiting, to tell the truth, I'm actually waiting on an answer back. But whether I hear an answer back or not, these things are going to
be. You're going to use the social network and internet to promote you. Yeah. Talking about that. But before that, I want to bring you back. Any features as producers-wise?
Producers, yeah, I got plenty. I got my boy Frankie Fatsack. I got Skin Deep on there. Nero the Kid, who actually is part of Velvet Trench Vibe, so he raps and he produces. Watch out. I got my boy E. Blaze, who's gone back to New York, who actually produced a track that I'm featuring with Medusa, a.k.a. Meriem Saki, who's in Nomadic Massive. That's sick, sick voice. We got a production by 6-2 on there, who's an underground legend as far as I'm concerned. If you look him up, he's one of the first guys to sell a significant amount of music on the internet from Canada. I can't dispute that. Of course, DJ Manifest is on there. Like we mentioned before, he produced All Good. Skin Deep actually produced 2 tracks on the album also, so... Like I said, that kid puts in work.
He does?
Yeah. BuddaBlaze produced on the track, on this old school track, tribute to old school track called The Story.
The Story. Any dates coming up?
Right now.
Besides the show in 10 minutes?
The only dates that I have right now are 2 days of sleeping. I did it all, like, all this has been done with by me and my close family and friends, and we're all tired. We didn't have the huge label behind us.
What's happening?
Just getting out and rep my boy, man. Just, you know,
coming out and rep your boy.
I'm saying, I have to pop into a little
bit. Why you not? I'm gonna let you two socialize. Bubbles, what's up,
bro? What's up?
How you doing? You good?
Good.
All right. Well, you know, we took it live. We took it to you. We took you backstage. And that's just the way it is. KCLMNOP Media Plus representing hip hop. You can't find realer than that. It's old school, like Google old school. Just Google it. How you doing, brother?
Good, you?
You good? I'm here.
Yeah,
I'm still, huh?
Doing the thing, man.
And I still got a good 28 seconds.
Like, when we get along, we don't stop getting along.
You know, that's the difference between, you know, street gangs and hip-hop kids. Zulu Nation's about making some of your self-esteem in shape. And hip-hop, you know, we ain't there to kill each other, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You can gather 5,000 of all old-school Montreal mother. Ain't nobody ever had beef with one another. This is hip-hop love, you know what
somebody
I mean? Zulu Nation
hurt.
Rule.
Yeah. But somebody could get
well, you know, people die still, you know.
Yeah,
you know? But that's not hip-hop, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Hip-hop is kids, don't be violent.
Exactly.
You know? Yeah, I have to represent, you know, being
you
cool.
Be careful.
Hey, they have to be careful, you know.
Yeah.
Snooze your lips.